What's good, ninjas? Mauro from Design Syndrome here, your graphic design dojo, where we'll learn the dark arts of graphic design and Photoshop. Glad to have you here back on the channel, and in this video I'll show you how to create this really crazy acid grungy distortion effect on Adobe Photoshop. It works amazing with type, graphic, images, and so you can use it for any kind of work, be it a poster, album cover, merch design. I even have a really neat trick to show you at the end of the video for that, so stick around to the end. So yeah, are you ready to achieve that final boss level of texture? Let's get it. So okay, first let's create our new document. I'm gonna make this 5,000 by 3,000, 300 dpi, everything good. Let's create it. Let's turn the background to black. And I'm just gonna type something here with a good old, oh, impact. It's already selected. There is no need to raster the type for this effect. And I'll show you how to create this effect with a brush pack that I've created. Don't worry, this is a free brush pack. It's called the Acid Light. It has a couple of brushes and also a couple of textures. You can get it from designsyndrome.com as part of the Shinobi stash. You can also grab it from the link below. So once you've installed the brush pack that I already have it installed here, we're gonna create a new layer on top of our graphics or text. And we are gonna reset the fore and background colors to black and white by pressing here above the color palette. And this is important also that you set the text to white and the background to black, because we're later gonna colorize it with a gradient map. So it's important that we have that nice control with the dark and clear values. So now with the brush tool selected in the new layer, I'm gonna use the color white here. Make sure the opacity is at 100%, and I'm gonna just start creating the distortions, like clicking for example here. You have to do two clicks depending on the brush because it has some texture. And now with the shortcut X, I'm gonna flip the colors from fore to background. So now I'm using black, and I'm gonna offset my stroke just a little bit to create that sort of lip you see there. And just like that, I'm gonna go around our graphic, just creating these distortions. Remember to invert your brushes. You can skew them, you can rotate them around. You can even make like an inverted lip by starting with the black shape and then offsetting with the white color, and you get something like this that looks really cool. And right now we are just focusing on big shapes. And just like this, we are sculpting our distortions, overlapping the white with the black strokes. So once we have something interesting, we're gonna have a layer combo that we've used before to make a sort of difumination pattern, so everything merges a bit more. This will really help us to see the piece a bit more finished before we keep adding texture to it. And you know what, we'll use the good old big noise plus gradient map combo, but we'll make the pointygize pattern a little bit different this time. So first we're gonna create a new layer. We're gonna fill it with edit fill, 50% gray. Here, make sure that your fore and background colors are still black and white, because we're gonna go now to filter gallery, and it works with those fore and background colors. And here I already had it selected under the sketch tab. Look for the reticulation pattern. Here I have deleted those. And under the reticulation pattern, the foreground level and background level doesn't really matter, but under the intensity, anything from 30 to 40 should work all right. Let's press okay. Perfect, and you see how we get like this. It's similar to the pointygize pattern, but it has like a different kind of texture. You can try it also with the pointygize noise and it looks amazing. But for this one, I wanted to show you another technique of doing this pointygize method. So let's turn the blending mode to hard mix, and the fill anything from 60 to 70%. So 75, so 65, sorry. And you see how we get that nice defumination pattern all over the texture. And look how this is integrating the texture we are producing for our graphic in a way that has much more character. It's like a really crazy displacement map, but you're doing it manually, but you get much more control of whatever you want to do. Okay, next we're gonna add the gradient map on top of the noise. And now for the color, we're gonna pick something that's gonna be more out there, you know? Here you can pick any color combination you want, really, if it's gonna be displayed on the screen. But for the sake of the tutorial, let's say we are doing this graphic to be applied on a black hoodie, which means we're gonna need to separate our graphic from the black background later down the line. So let's try to make this with that in mind, a little real world scenario for you there. So let's start our gradient with black at the bottom. And as we move up the values, play with saturated and unsaturated hues and tones so we get that really nice acidic feel to it. Like for example, play with some green midtones, then jump to reds or violets for the high midtones, something really contrasty and saturated. And then for the brighter parts, just like an off-white, something that contrasts with the previous orange that we picked. Something like this looks amazing. Bring the values a bit closer together so we get like a nice gradation. Something like this works for me. So once we have our gradient, we're gonna start to add in those nice little details to the texture. And for that, let's add a new layer just below our original stains that we did. And now with the brush, and you're gonna start playing with the black and white, switching quickly with the X like we did for the first stains. And we're gonna turn down the opacity of the brushes to something like even 20 to 15%. And just like that, we're gonna start adding really subtle value variation within our graphic. This is making that when the new values go over the threshold of our reticulation pattern, they will show colorized because of the layers we have on top. You see, if I get rid of the gradient map and the reticulation pattern, what we are doing really is painting in the midtones so they show through the reticulation pattern. Now I'm painting with black, but if I do white and I start doing, for example, over here, if I bring the reticulation pattern back, you can see how it's starting to show, but in a way that's much more integrated with the graphic itself, right? And here, get really creative, play with the eraser tool, create new layers on top or below the original graphic that we did to really break up that composition. And remember that the key here is to play with the black and white strokes in different opacities, so we let the layers on top do the magic. By the way, guys, with this free pack alone, you can pull off some amazing results. But if you feel like beefing up your arsenal even further while you support the channel so I can keep making these videos, I've made a full acid brush pack with over 70 acid brushes and 30 high quality textures, and also the acid gradient map packs with over 40 really vibrant acid gradient maps ready to go. These tools are all about helping you save time and experiment further with your ideas. They are both also available on bundle form, 30% off. You can get it at designsyndrome.com. So yeah, check them out if you feel like it. Moving back to the tutorial. So okay, up to here we have created some really nice value gradation that's making that really gnarly texture to come through. And now I'm going to show you a new application for texture images that you might not have thought about. I'm gonna grab just any texture. These are from the full acid pack, but you have free textures on the free acid light. So I'm just gonna make it so it takes up the entire canvas. And now we're gonna duplicate the original gradient map that we had. And going back to the texture, we're gonna go Control or Command A to select everything. We're gonna go Control C or Command C to copy, then Control or Command D to get rid of the selection. Here we can hide or delete the texture altogether. And now pressing Alt click on the mask of the gradient map, we're gonna enter the mask channel. And in here, we're gonna paste with Control or Command B. And then we're gonna go back to the RGB channel by pressing any thumbnail. And here what we did really, it's using the information in the texture itself to use it as the mask. And now let's edit our new gradient map and we can change some of the hues in the values that we got. something like this works really amazing, I feel. You can even reverse it to get like this really crazy application of the gradient map, but for the purpose of what we're doing, it's not really working, but looks really cool. And you can even customize this further if you click on the mask. You no need to go into the mask channel again. You can go again with the brushes and you can start sculpting it like this. If you paint with black, you can see how we can start to affect the mask itself. So yeah, this is a really nice way to add just another dimension to apply the texture in the color itself. What's really cool about this layer setup is that the effect is being rendered live, so you can go back and edit the different brush strokes and even the gradient maps, trying some really crazy color combinations. If I was using this for web, I would probably close this with a nice paper texture. This is from the Papercut texture pack. There is a free version, of course, to around fill around 40%. Then curves adjustment to add just a bit more contrast. And if it was for digital, this would be it and I would call it a day. But if this was for a garment or anything that you need to get rid of the black pixels, let me get rid of the texture and the curves adjustment, I would put everything within a group. And then on the group, if you go to the effects panel and the blending options, let's make a nice zoom so I can see properly the pixels. We have the blend if sliders. And on the current layer one, if we separate the left node just a bit, you'll see how the pure black pixels go away. And because I knew we're going to use this method, this is why on the gradient maps, I set the initial point for both of them as black, because I knew I was gonna need those black pixels to then be able to isolate them like this. Then if you press Alt, you see we have here the black pixels, but they are just a little bit janky, you know? If we press Alt and click that little triangle the node has right there, you can see how we separate it. And what this does is that it smoothens the transition from the hidden values that we're trying to hide here, right? If you take it all the way to the right, you see how everything kind of fades. But we just want that little part with the black background meets with the darkest part of our graphics. So around there, you see how we start to lose some of that greenish, darker value that we have. So something around there works. And just like that, you can export it as a transparent PNG and it's ready to use in any garment. So yeah, that was it. I hope you liked it and hopefully learned something. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already and click the notify bell button so you don't miss any of the new videos coming out. Really, my G's, thank you so much for watching. See you on the next one. You already know how it is. Fuck peace. Wish you conflict. Shit.